Welcome to the today's presentation. The topic of the presentation is insecticide poisoning. Herein we will talk about the various chemical insecticide which are being used nowadays in the livestock farming. Basically, insecticides are the substance used to kill insecticides, and they includes ovicides and larvicides, which are mostly used against the insect eggs and larvae, which are the vectors of the many bacterial and viral diseases. Insecticides are nowadays widely used in agriculture and livestock farming, and insecticides, which are claimed to be a major factor behind the increase in the 20th century agriculture productivity, means to increase the productivity of agricultural sector as well as livestock farming or livestock sector also, whenever these insecticides are used judiciously. Otherwise, with the inadvertent use of insecticides and pesticides during the livestock farming or even agriculture farming leads to several kind of toxicity, either to human beings or and animals also. Some of them are they become concentrated as they spread along the food chain also. So one should keep an eye over and the insecticide when they will be used in the field or in livestock farming. They should be used judiciously, and inadvertent use of insecticide always should be used judiciously. In fact, as far as the insecticides available for use, they can be categorized or classified on the basis of chemical nature. For the sake of study, I had grouped or came here with only four kind of insecticides. Out of them, organochlorine is one. And DDT, organochlorine, and example of organochlorine is DDT, aldrin, and lindane. Second one is organophosphorus insecticide. The example of organophosphorus insecticide is parathion, sumithion, and malathion. And third one in the list is carbamate poisoning, the aldicarb and carbaryl. Example of the carbamate insecticides, whereas some synthetic pyrethroid used in the mosquito repellent, they are cypermethrin and permethrin. In the coming slide, we will go through the mechanism of toxicity, their symptoms, sign, and PM lesion. Also, at the end, we will discuss about the probable way for diagnosis of this insecticide poisoning. The first one is organochlorine insecticide toxicity. The mechanism of toxicity could be explained as the animal as the insecticide is a neuropoison, and by virtue of their high lipid solubility, they easily enters the neural membrane and interfere with the sodium potassium channel of the membrane, and sometimes particularly lindane causes toxicity by inhibiting GABA-dependent chlorine influx. As far as clinical symptoms in the toxicity is concerned, the animal shows sign of simultaneous stimulation of CNS followed by depression and death due to respiratory failure. In case of chronic poisoning, liver damage, hypoglycemia, and hypokalemia may be noted. The symptoms of aldrin poisoning is more severe than the DDT, as we have discussed earlier. DDT is a more potent insecticide as compared with the DDT. Aldrin is the more potent insecticide as compared with the DDT, and the symptoms characterized by teeth grinding, dyspnea, and frequent urination. The necropsy lesion found in the toxicity or in such toxicity is mostly confined to nervous system. However, due to acute eldrin poisoning, hepatitis and tubular necrosis may be noticed. In case of chronic toxicity, centrilobular necrosis may be also noticed. As far as diagnosis is concerned, it can be diagnosed on the basis of history, sign, and PM lesion sometimes. And analysis of feet and or blood or milk sample are done for the traces of insecticides in themselves. Also, a morbid specimen can be used for analysis of these insecticides or traces of these insecticides. Differential diagnosis must be done as in toxicity due to salt poisoning, strychnine poisoning, and fluorocetate poisoning. The symptoms are almost same, but differential diagnosis must be done before arriving at any diagnosis. The next in the series is organophosphorus insecticide toxicity. On the basis of activities, organophosphorus insecticide toxicity can be classified into direct acting organophosphorus insecticide and indirect acting organophosphorus insecticides. The example for direct acting organophosphorus insecticide is dichlorobas, TEPP, chlorothion, antifos, and malathion and parathion are widely used in the market nowadays. And this is an example of indirect acting organophosphorus insecticide toxicity. The next one is carbamate insecticide toxicity. The mechanism of toxicity as far as mechanism of toxicity is concerned, carbamates are the potent and reversible inhibitor of cholinesterase enzyme, whereas acetylcholinesterase inhibition by organophosphorus insecticides is reversible. This should be kept in mind whenever talking about mechanism of toxicity. As far as clinical symptoms or sign is concerned, it is similar to the organophosphorus insecticide poisoning, but the severity of the sign and symptoms is less in carbamate poisoning as compared with the organophosphorus insecticides. As far as postmortem lesion is concerned, the congestion and edema of lung, liver, and kidney is most often appreciated. The next and the last type of insecticide toxicity is synthetic pyrethroid insecticide poisoning. The cypermethrin and permethrin are the classical example of synthetic pyrethroids. This cypermethrin and permethrin are synthetic neuropoison, and the main target of action is the nerve membrane sodium potassium channel. The clinical sign in the acute poisoning of this synthetic pyrethroid insecticide toxicity in lab animal are restlessness, incoordination, hyperactivity, tremor, prostration, and paralysis. Overall, this toxicity is also referred, and the symptoms or syndrome is also referred to as T syndrome. As far as diagnosis of such toxicity is concerned, this is based on clinical sign, and almost identical symptoms could be seen in any organochlorine poisoning. This is all about today's discussion, and now the session is open for healthy discussion. Thank you.